told me that my dad drove Muni and had gator skin shoes on and hats, fedoras and stuff, and diamonds and stuff. And he said half the people didn't even know that he was tweaking because they was tweaking too. My dad was very bossy, dominant, and opinionated, but he also raised bossy, dominant, opinionated children. And he instilled values that you either liked or you loved or you hated, but they were in you once you heard him, because he had a word that resonated throughout your ear, your heart, and everything. And because of my dad and how funny style he was, he raised his daughters to stand up for what you believe in and to not fall for anything. My dad has messed up some of my relationships without knowing, because he funny style, I'm funny style. And when I'm dealing with someone and not sure if I want to deal with them, I say, what would my dad say? Would he approve of this situation? Sometimes I want to do it anyway, but he was still in my ear. So with that being said, when my dad was diagnosed, it came as a surprise for us. He had just had his neck surgery 6 months prior, which could have killed him or paralyzed him. And he recovered in 3 months when it should have been 6 months. So we thought, he won, we did this.
Yeah.
And when he got his diagnosis, and when Lavelle told me that, they were sitting in the car and they told him, terminal? She said all they could do is sit and laugh. And then the car wouldn't start, so they couldn't do nothing else but sit and laugh. And they gave him 2 months to live. And my dad lived a year and 2 months. So that tells you that the devil is a lie. And in that whole year my dad lived, he got 6, 7 good months of happiness and joy. And like the grandkids said, he was the glue that brought us together. Lavelle, you know, we bump heads, we argue, but we still family. And can't nothing take away what you did with my dad. Not just when he was sick. They've been together 28 years. Married 18, but together 28 years. He shared every milestone with Lavelle and with Kamari and with the joint family. And you did that. And you being there enabled me and my sister to do something I didn't think I could do. I didn't think I could be a caregiver. I didn't think I could take care of nobody sick. I don't even change Band-Aids. But my dad said, walk with Lavelle and don't leave her alone. And me and my sister moved in and took turns until we got into it with him, we'd alternate. And I was able to help take care of my dad, took off work, and was able to help assist Lavelle. And I was glad I was able to do that for my dad, and I have no regrets. And I just want everyone to continue to remember Steve Speedy Brown the way that he was. Not a man who was sick, but a man who had style and grace, who invented the swag. I love you, Dad.